Hello, welcome to another little video on phy mapping. Today we're going to look at a few prey animals and specifically their faces. I've got these. I'm not sure exactly who took these three. This one was taken by Gary Bendig, great photograph. And we've got a goat, an antelope, a horse, and a rabbit. Fairly random smattering there. But hopefully it will be interesting. So we've got some shapes we can look at, some area maps, basically the two different patterns, phi and fib. Phi center, and this one's going to the fib corner, and then some line maps that exist within those, within the area maps. So try and find a nice rectangle here. Right off the bat, and that is not going to. So that looks like the primary rectangle right there, or arguably, yeah, okay, well, maybe that's it then. Goes to the horns up there from this perspective. It's a 2D, 3D thing happening, but still, we'll say that's a, those are good edges. Will be the width of the ears. But at the same time, this is almost a tighter one. That one's almost better. And if that's the case, then the ears might be like that. And the horns, again, from this perspective, also be like that. So, okay, that's probably the primary rectangle there. And that may carry through. I say this is an antelope. It's got to be a young, maybe a young antelope. Or just straight from Disney. Okay. It's also going to have this one, the width of the ears will be this big one, and then the inner one is going to be about the size of the head there. So let's take your pick. The horse. Those inner ones work really well, so I'm guessing that's probably about the right size, which is tip to tip there. And this one is, the ears would include that upper body, putting those ones relatively harmonically too, so that's probably also the one there. Harmonically, because it's between the eyes, lining the cheek to cheek there. Well, let's see. Doing something like that, maybe. Cool. Okay, let's look at, we could do just a grid. Let's try a grid. Haven't done that in a little while. Those little clusters of squares are spirals. So that'll put a spiral right in the eyes and the nostrils, framing about the width of front of the mouth. Is wild. It's like right on the front lip. Wants to go right through the eyelashes. Possibly. Sure. Nice. Very nice. Okay, let's try the 5 spiral map. Right between the horns, right to the nose, and that's really good. Also really good. Keep that going. Also really good. Yeah, that works well on the goat. That, wow, I mean that one plus the eye one. Very nice. I can See that sort of oval seed shape in there? That is almost doing the ear. Not quite, I guess. Not quite. That's how you get those nostrils, they're just so small. That middle channel should be shooting directly into in through the ear there, traveling in through the ear there. Yeah, basically. So that sort of beautiful dynamic there, is that right? Similar to this. That white spot going right in the middle of the channel, and then this going side to the eyes. Maybe. Beautiful. Get those eyes right in the middle of the of that spiral thing. And the nose right on there. Nose on there. Yeah, I guess it maybe it's up a bit. It's almost like the nose and the eyes don't want to work perfectly. Little 2D, 3D thing maybe. Yeah, because it's very nice when the eyes are like that. The nose is right there. Mouth is there. Whiskers coming out there. And the ears in there. Beautiful. And also doing that. Beautiful. Beautiful. Okay, let's try the line map here. It should reinforce some things. Maybe that's it. Cool. Scale that down one scale, 61.8% from that one. What does it do? It gives us that, right? Right. Make those horns match. All right, that was that. Yeah. So to make them match this way is a little bit smaller. What's that? That's the full height. Yeah. There's something just slightly skewy here. But anyway, let's not get bogged down in the details. It's basically that. Cool. Width of the mouth. Could be. Yeah, kind of. Neat, neat, neat. And we'll try this guy. Just on the off chance, we've got some pointy things here. Maybe, just maybe. Spirals on the eyes. Or in the void. Oh, yeah. Right, okay, so from the horn to the bottom of the mouth, even though 2D, 3D, and that big sweep right there. That is. Yeah, a little messy, but it's there somewhere, doing that little tiny mouth. Yeah, this has got to be the one. Put the, see, it's doing that, kind of doing the ear thing, that this line up there. Sort of inventing it, but it's also sort of there. Putting the eyes. Yeah, they want to be right in the spiral. If the eyes are on the spiral, that goes fairly good with the nose. Then loses the horns, though. Well, yeah, loses the horns a bit. But does that ear shape in there really well. And puts the horns sort of on these spirals. Losing those spirals, but moving the eyes to there. Yeah, yep, changing, constantly changing. The shifting sands of Phi. Also not bad there. In fact, very good there, I think. Pretty good. Neat. Could be, but that's pretty good. Eyes right in those slots. Maybe it's that actually. Eyes right in the cross. Just those swoops coming down feel like they fit well right above those eyes. And doing a little bit of the hair feel there. That's really good too. Yeah, something like that though. Cool. in a bunch of points. A little bit messy, but... some complex stuff like that. I'm trying to find that ear. But yeah, basically, that's fantastic. Yeah, they all worked well. They all worked well. Obviously an oval shape though. Nice. Okay. Well, there we go. Hopefully that was interesting. And hopefully we'll get to see you on another one. Thanks very much. Take care out there, and we'll see you again.